Yeah, go ahead and light that. I know you're feeling it. I know you're feeling it. Uh-huh. Yeah, go ahead and light that. I know you're feeling it. Know what you're dealing with? Uh-huh. Yeah, go ahead and light that. I know you're feeling it. I know you're feeling it. Whether you like it or not, I'ma get mine. Gotta fight for the spot. What? Come and tussle with the unpredictable one. Bear hug, what I mean by unconditional love. A high fly from the top buckle, I'm untouchable. You gon' wish you wasn't alive for a month or two.
Sort of work out. If you can't do it, don't be in it. You have to be in it to be able to do it. Right, Bobby?
Uh-huh, yeah, go ahead and light that. I know you're feeling it. I know you're feeling it. Uh-huh, yeah, go ahead and light that. I know you're feeling it.
My friends say, they say, Simon, what are you so excited about today? I tell them I'm excited about January 17th.
The WUW presents its 30-year anniversary show. 30 years of producing some of the greatest stars this industry has ever seen. From Taz to Matt Stryker to Devon Dudley.
30th anniversary, Johnny Rods. I couldn't be happier. Because you see, if it wasn't for you, I wouldn't be here today. One half of the greatest tag team in the history of this business. 24 world tag team titles and 2 television titles. The most decorated tag team in the history of this business. And it's all because of you, Johnny.
Hola amigo, les habla su amigo Super Crazy para invitarlos este 17 de enero. 17 de enero, no lo olviden, para celebrar el 30 aniversario del club de WUW. Los esperamos en el Glacier Gym. Ahí estaré, Super Crazy.
Super Crazy, it's been too long waiting for my rematch, sucker. Your green card, Hall of Burrito eating piece of crap. Oh, did I hurt your feelings? Did I strike a nerve?
I hear that there's 2 guys looking for a fight. One of them being David Finley Jr. Another one would be the WWE's light heavyweight champion, Takaaki Watanabe.
I am WWE champion. My tag partner, David Finley, got the belt from Germany. My tag team, best in the world.
Dastardly princes of Dubai with not once, but twice got themselves disqualified.
America is an honorable thing. I'm not fair. Hello.
He's done it once, he's done it twice, and he's ready to do it the 3rd time. He's going to beat up the Celtic Connection, and he's going to embarrass them in front of their family.
No, no.
So, if you guys want to fight, we're right here. And Mr. Watanabe, in case you haven't heard, the rules are, if myself or Payaso Coco pinned you, that title comes to either me or him.
But we've got 2 guys that think they can beat me and my partner here. Well, they're wrong. We've got Payaso Coco, a clown from Mexico. Well, it's not going to be fun and games. You're not going to be laughing. You want to go back to Mexico. We've got Money Mike Fire Zone. Well, you better save your money because the hospital bills are going to be expensive. You both better hope Johnny Rods calls your moms and begs them not to let you out that night.
Definitely Jr. not coming for you. What, Bobby? What you holding? WWE Champion Super Crazy, I'ma get you first.
In Brooklyn, New York. Yosh.
I'm here to make a point. I'm here to make a name for myself. And if I have to go through you to make a name for myself, then so be it. It's after January 17th, Devon. You will know the name Mike Iannuzzi.
May God help you, because I'm telling you, like I've told people in the past, number one, thou shall not steal, thou shall not kill, and most of all, thou shall not mess with the Dudley boys. Oh, my brother, oh, testify!
So bad that the pictures in your wallets are gonna cry, and you can take that to the bank.
Oh, and guess what? Woo! Damian Midas right on the middle of the cover. Yeah, come check me out. January 17th, everybody. Woo!
January 17th.
Welcome to the world of unpredictable wrestling. My name is Jay Heavy. Next to me is Crusher Kolvanov from Russia. Did I get that right there?
Listen to me, my pasty white friend. Kolvanov. Can you say it with me? Say it with me, please. Kovalov. This is my name.
Kovalov.
Kovalov. You see, you know, you're a frog in throat, but it's okay. Kovalov.
And also joining us tonight is Money Mike Firezone, who has a big match coming up later against Finley and Taka Watanabe from New Japan Wrestling. Money Mike.
You know what? I really don't care if you get his name right because, it's not even important. But one thing that is important, can I ask you something? Will you let me speak tonight?
Yes, but let's check out your matches later on. Here's a little tale of the tape, who's coming up tonight. We have Money Mike, Piazza Koso versus Finley Watanabe. You can see their stats there. Wow. And we'll also have the triple threat match coming up. Sumi Saki, Marcella.
Sumi Saki.
God. Sky D.
Whoa. You're talking about my friends there. Say it right. Sky D.
Oh. I did say Sky D, but I said it with a little, like, faster.
He has problems with, you know, talking. I know this is very hard.
From Russia. You should listen to the speech therapist from
Russia. I speak very
quickly. All right, guys. Can we get started here?
Yes, this is the 30th anniversary of the World of Unpredictable Wrestling. Another exciting evening here at the world-famous Gleason's Gym here in Brooklyn, New York. Starting our first match off, it looks like we have 8th Street in there. And who's the referee?
I don't know this guy. Who is this guy? You tell me my friend. Who is this guy?
I don't really pay attention that much to camera.
Long Island Larry? Long Island Larry is the referee. That
works.
That just came
Long
into
Island
the telephone.
Larry, okay. We see if he's on Peninsula or if he's on Point.
Oh, very good there, Crusher. All right, our first match is going to be HBO. Kiana.
You know what, Jay Heavy? Let me stop you right there. You see HBO? That's my boy right there.
How many people? It's already been there. HBO Kiana and Sleepy Jones coming into the ring, and they're your boys, huh?
You know what? I can tell you this for the longest time. Me and the Brotherhoods have been close for a very long time.
Well, Money Mike, I thought you were part of Prince Nero's camp there for a while, Stefaroo, but I heard you lost a lot of money with your hedge fund.
Whoa,
very mad at you, so.
Hey, let's not get into that right now. We're not here for that.
Listen, enough with this talk. I want to tell you something. I want you to watch the team of HBO Keon and Sleepy Jones, because they do not sleep on the job. I tell you this, very strong team, very powerful team. Sleepy Jones, the master of the suplex. I know this because I do this in the ring for years myself. So you watch the match, you learn something. Stop with the talk. Watch the match. Thank you.
You heard it from Crusher. I'm not going to argue with him. He is really violent today. I guess he didn't take his meds there, Mike.
Meds? What you talk? I really?
Said you might need
okay,
some
now we
help.
Look. I've seen these boys before. Keanu Vera,
look who it is.
Steve Pena.
It's Keanu Vera and Steve Pena.
Yes, and they're upcoming title match coming up, I heard, against maybe the Celtic Connection coming up in the future, or Prince Nero Stefaroo with the outcome of the match tonight.
You know what, Jay Heavy? That's a match that I would love to see, because you got four guys with extreme talent.
Very athletic, very agile team in Vera and Peña. I've seen them before with these two. It's going to be a very strong match. I guarantee this. Watch for very powerful moves, and during the course of the match, watch for many high spots, possibly. Possibly.
Thank you, Karloff. Is that it?
Kovalov,
my mistake. Oh my God, my mistake. I'm just gonna call you Crusher from now on.
Just call me Double K, baby.
Double K.
That's right.
What are your thoughts on this match? You think Steve Pena and Keanu Vera have a chance against these two?
Well, I tell you this from the get-go. You never know what's going to happen in this place because it's unpredictable like our name. However, my money this time, I bet you anything. Right, Money? You know what money is. You put that money down, baby. If you're going to put it down, I put it down on Sleepy Jones and HBO Keon.
You know what, my friend? I have to agree with you on that. HBO Keon and Sleepy Jones, they have the experience.
Nice lockup. You see what he's doing with his knife? That's what I'm talking about. A nice reversal. Tremendous. What do you think, Jay?
Don't count this Steve Pena out. Look at that little move he just pulled. Wow, look at that.
Trying to a side headlock.
Side headlock trying to squeeze that nut. But nice reversal. And into a side headlock of his own. Talented, baby, I tell you this.
Pena off the rope. What's going to happen here?
Nice. I like show the tackle like a strong, like boom. Run into wall. Drop down. He comes over against the ropes. Up Listen, I'm talking Flyboy, huh? Back of elbow. Oh. Go for cover.
Well, too soon, I would think.
Too close.
Too soon.
Not yet, baby. He's not going to stay down like that if you don't cover him like that.
Here comes Keanu.
Yes. Come on, referee. Get him out. Get him out. This guy, what is his name from Long Island? What?
I don't Long know. Island Larry is the referee.
Long Island Larry. Very nice. Very nice.
He seems to be locked in one corner. And oh, nice takedown.
Deep arm drive. Another deep arm drive. He's getting very deep. And drop kick.
Drop kick.
Right in his bush. Get out of the ring. That's right. Take it, referee. Oh, I'm getting very excited. I don't know.
Crusher, what is a wuss?
A wuss? Listen, wuss? You look in the mirror, then you know what wuss is.
No, okay, I asked you, you just said he got hit in the wuss.
He got hit in the mush. Hey, what? You
I thought he was hit in the chest.
You don't know how to pronounce things. That's what your problem is.
A wuss is a fuss.
Guys, look at this.
Tucson, look at that.
Look at the action that's going on here.
Wow, you've seen it happening right here. It looks like, who is that out there, Kiana? Kiana's got the upper hand on...
Jay Heavy, let me ask you something. What is it with you and names?
What is it? Wait a
it's
second.
It's Keanu.
Oh, look, you talk together and you missed
me.
That's very nice. Very strong. Come on, HBO. Come on, baby. You show him. He's the human box office. And now comes in this part.
Keon, not Keanu.
Hey, I see Keon. HBO Keon. I have accent because I don't speak English.
Guys, look at his action right here.
It's Money Mike that ends everything with a vowel.
Yes, first you mess up with Sumisaki.
I didn't say Sumisaki yet, but wait. Since we're talking about Sumisaki, we have a great match coming up. A triple threat match. Sumisaki versus Marcella and Sky D. What?
Look what's going on. My God. Big, strong slam on the counter. And he's... What's he going to do? What's
elbow.
Oh, boy.
Leg drop.
That's right, baby. I love that leg drop. That leg drop crushes him. Nope. That's my name. I know these things.
Wait, are you the one that showed him that leg drop?
Well, I'm not saying nothing. People aren't forget him. What, are you writing book or something?
We don't have time to write book. I'm just asking you a simple question, yes or no.
Guys, stop fighting, please.
I like that. Very nice. Into the corner, and he's working on his back.
Guys, I want to point out one thing with Sleepy Jones. He may not look it, but this man is as strong as they come.
Beautiful.
Sleepy Jones is now taking advantage. But we are watching this match here. Sleepy Jones now tagging off. But that's right, March 21st, the power wheel is turning. Tickets are now on sale, 718-797-2872. That's March 21st.
Very, very strong.
Very. Look at Keon sneaking that in there. Sleepy now going, is there a tag? I didn't see a tag. Did you see a tag?
There was no tag there.
You look like you talk. You don't see because you don't say. Look, he's very strong. He comes in with the tag. I saw tag.
You did not see a tag because a tag did not take place.
No, I know.
So, this close to losing it.
Almost close. Close only counts in horseshoes and hand grenades. Okay? That's all good. Second place is long line list of losers.
Losers. So who's going to lose this match out of your wrestling experience Crusher?
In my experience, I say to you, I know that Vera and Peña have been doing a lot of touring as of late, so they're quite exhausted. Oh, what's this?
What a move!
Very, very, very bad for them.
Peña.
I don't like to see
taking
this.
The upper advantage now. Look at that. Like what were you saying about traveling and exhausted?
Well, you know, I might be wrong because maybe he took electrolytes or something. I don't know.
Electrolytes.
But now he's in the ring and he's doing well, and I like this. And see, he's
nice.
Stomped mud hole in his chest.
He's going to have trouble breathing tonight.
No, I think he's going to walk it dry.
Now, Money Mike, being a ring veteran of yourself, what is going on in Steve Peña's head right now after being shocked like that?
Right now, the only thing that could be going through his mind is, how can I put these guys away as quickly as possible so I don't take as much damage as they're going to dish out?
Excuse me. Look. This is what I love about this. Super strong. This is... Oh. He's going... Oh, no.
He looks like he's...
Bring him back up.
He's losing him.
Hold him, baby. Come on. The blood rushing to the head.
That's
beautiful. This is why he is the suplex master here at the world of...
You know what, Jay Heavy? to your question before, I think right now Steve Pena ain't thinking about anything.
I don't think so. After his head just got driven into the canvas like that, that is definitely a brutal move. Two. Oh.
Saved by his partner,
Vera.
Yes. This is. And look, now that. Now you that, see the tag? That, now you see the tag.
Now I see the tag, yes.
Now, then that's strong right to his chest.
Oh, look at that kick.
Side of the head. Many, many impacts. He is a very strong impacting wrestler.
Oh!
That is beautiful!
Oh, the jawbreaker.
I wonder how many teeth he has left in his face now.
I saw one hit that guy in the front row. He looks like he's taking it out of his hair right now.
I think Pena's jaw is in the first or second row.
This is it. Looks like it's over with. I have to agree with Crusher. This team just outdid him.
Wow.
And oh, he moved!
A last second desperation move. Pena still has some fuel in the tank. Maybe a couple of things left upstairs. I don't know how much right now. Looks like he's crawling in to tag off his partner. HBO is still down. Crusher, what would you do in this circumstance? What do you have? Any advice out there?
My advice to HBO, tag, get the strongman in. That way you pound him into submission. Oh, but look what happens. First is, now we have Vera in with clothesline. Now, what are you going to do? Now, what are you going to do? What are you going to... Now he hits him again. Money Mike, what would you do?
Well, what I do, straight from that hot tag, I'd be all over HBO Keon.
It looks like he's getting him a little room there, and I have to agree with you too on that. Look at that. That just registered. Wow.
Once again, in the mush. In the mush.
What does that even mean?
In the mush. I show you later.
Well, right now, he calls a wuss a chest in Russia. But I don't understand that. Now, look at this. He's going off the rope. What's going to happen here? He ducks the clothesline. Wow! Did you see that elbow?
Come on, Sleepy. Come on, baby. Come on, get up.
Wow, Long Island Larry's still in there. He's counting.
This referee, I'm telling you, he's letting things get out of hand in the middle of the ring.
I never saw Long Island Larry before. It's the first time I ever seen him here.
Well, maybe we don't see him again afterwards, maybe.
I don't know. You might be right, Crusher.
What's going on here? And, oh, boy, this is not good. I've seen this go before, and he got down. He could not hold it. I tell you, they are exhausted from being on the road so much.
I don't know. Stuff. I've seen him. It looks like he's having a knee problem.
Look at this. And he nails it.
Whoa, that was a move. Look at that.
Yes, that was strong. That was very strong.
And remember, we have more exciting wrestling coming up on March 21st. The Power Wheel is turning here at the World of Unpredictable Wrestling. Another action-packed show coming up on March 21st. Get your tickets now.
And we have now, look, his referee is counting both, and now we have pin. Two. What? Two count? Come on, referee. Come on. Oh, it should have only been one count.
Well, both these guys look exhausted here. Looks like who's going to tag first? Does Pena have enough to go in there? It's a tag. Pena comes in. Whoa. A nice kick. Whoa, it's going to be a suplex. The suplex master. Look at this.
He's got him up.
Taken from Sleepy Jones. A little.
Very impressed.
Come on, Brotherhoods.
A little receipt
I'm very
there.
Impressed.
Wow. What was that, a four?
He's in the ring. Brings him up. This looks
Hits
him with that finisher. That. Straight savant kick to his head as he's in a fireman's carry. One, two, and
yeah,
HBO,
nice
baby.
Save
that's
by
right,
HBO.
Baby. You work with your partner. Save him, save him.
Wow, you just saw one registering
kick. He pushes
kick.
The ref.
Up. What happened? He hit him in the face with a foot.
Yeah, it looked like he got whiplash from the rope. I'm not too sure on that, but he is down. Whoa, he just threw him out. And remember, Mikey, you got a big match coming up later with Finley. I heard there's some smack talk on the street and in the locker rooms that this Finley going to do a number on you with his partner Watanabe. You have any thoughts on that?
Who?
Finley Jr. David Finley Jr.
Oh, him?
Yes.
You really think I have to be worried about somebody like him?
Ooh,
I mean, come on. I'm Money Mike.
And that is it, ladies and gentlemen. You see what happens? You're talking about match with you and Finley. And you
missed the ending
you
there.
You know, this is just like Amerikanskis that you are. You don't watch, you don't know. I'm telling you, Michael, Mr. Firezone, you're going to beat Finley. I know this for a fact.
Wow, unhappy crowd there. Look at that.
Ultra Heavy, I told you. You asked me who I thought was going to win. I said HBO Kia.
Crusher, yes, you are right. I will buy you that bottle of Stoli and we'll have a drink later.
If I like you, I drink with you. I don't like you.
Oh, that's good. I'll save the bottle of Stoli for me and Money Mike here.
Whoa, no, I'm going to drink with Kovalov after this one.
All right, baby, we're going to tear up the town. And look, very good showing for this up-and-coming team of Peña and Vera. But they did not have tonight what it takes to be unpredictable.
Look. January 17th, the world of unpredictable wrestling has its 30th anniversary show here in Gleason's Gym. The names that are on the show are unbelievable. You got Super Crazy, you got Devon Dudley, you got Marcella, you got Sumisaki. It keeps going. But you know what? I hear that there's two guys looking for a fight. One of them being David Finley Jr. Another one would be the WWE's light heavyweight champion, Takaaki Watanabe. Guys, you're looking for a fight. Me and my partner, that's right, my partner and my buddy from Mexico City, Payaso Coco, are coincidentally looking for two guys to have a match with. So, if you guys want to fight, we're right here. And Mr. Watanabe, in case you haven't heard, the rules are, if myself or Payaso Coco pins you, that title comes to either me or him. Get ready. See you January 17th.
Welcome back to the world of unpredictable wrestling. We had an exciting first match there. And we also have a March 21st. The Power Wheel is turning. Another exciting show here at the World of Unpredictable Wrestling. So get ready. I don't know what this is. What do you call this, Crusher?
I don't know what you call this. I'm trying to look, but I do not believe what I am seeing. Oh, boy. What is that?
I don't know what it is. We have a musketeer,
What is this? This
little guy.
Wonderful world of Disney. I do not understand what's going on here. Musketeer? Okay. I don't see chocolate bars. What's going on?
He must be a musketeer in training. This is a musketeer. And who's this little guy here? Oh,
this is nice little kid. I know this kid. This is a nice little young man. Very, very, very good kid.
Okay. And we have, it's definitely not Miss Liberty, but it's Boy Diva Rick.
This is Guy?
I think so.
Oh, my God. I thought it was retired shot putter from my country.
Look at those arms. You might be right.
Well, this is... Look at... Wow. You know something? I'm glad Colonel Sanders is dead because he'd be looking for legs like that for his bucket. Wow.
I would not want a bucket with those legs.
This is very disturbing to me. This is not good. Wow. This looks like a wow.
I don't know what the little guy is, but he's sitting there watching, and the musketeer is on the air.
Faction in the history of World of Unpredictable Wrestling. Is everyone having fun?
Well, I guess it's honoring the 30th anniversary.
This is much tradition being celebrated tonight. That is why they are all coming out of the closet, maybe? I don't know. Don't believe me.
There's a lot of jumping around here, and Rick, Reverend Rick, whatever, it's Rick Ravishing, or... Well, WUW always has interesting and great shows. We definitely...
Unpredictable, baby, that's right, the name.
Very unpredictable.
You never know. That's right.
The little guy. Thank you.
Nightlight. That's what we call him. He's very good kid. I love this. Is really good. Nice kid.
Wow, this is really...
And wee. Oh, look at him.
Oh, it's the 30th anniversary.
This is very great to start. I like this. Very happy times.
Well, this is kicking off our ladies' match.
The one on the right is scaring me. I don't know.
Scaring a lot of people right now. Well, this is a way we're kicking off our ladies' match, which is coming up next, and it sure
Well, I tell you one thing right now. After seeing this, I can tell you one thing for sure. This is no lady. Watch out, guys. Be careful. But I do understand Rick is a very talented wrestler. But maybe someday we see it. And hopefully, I will not be in locker room when that time comes. Okay.
I don't want to be in that locker room either. So we'll leave it at that note. And we have an exciting ladies match coming up March 21st. A big show coming up here. What are your thoughts on that, Crusher?
The 21st. Big show coming up. Next phase.
At this time, we'd like to acknowledge our sponsor, world-famous Gleason's Gym, 77 Front Street, Dumbo, Brooklyn, for all your boxing, pro wrestling, and martial arts training. 718-797-2872.
Ladies and gentlemen,
all right, we're kicking off the ladies' match. Ave Street's on the mic right now making an announcement. We have Sky D from Mexico following Marcelo up there. They had a big grudge down there in south of the border of Mexico. Sumisaki, our ladies' champion, and Marcella battling it out. This will be for the WUW title. Jonathan Ganji is our referee, and we're in for an exciting match here. What are your thoughts on this, Crusher?
Well, I tell you one thing right now. Marcella has been running all over the place trying to avoid Sky D from what I understand in locker room, my friend.
Well, she came up to New York and Sky D hopped on a plane and followed her this time. So we're in for some wild match here.
Yes, yes.
And it looks like she's announced right now, Sky D.
Sky D, wow, this is big woman. Very strong, I like this
and
type
a mess.
Of person.
Wow, she is a big woman.
Look at this. She's an animal, I tell you. That's right, baby. You'll show everybody the world just how strong you are.
CML, Mexican superstar Sky D, following Marcel up here, and it looks like the grudge is now going to take place here in Brooklyn, New York. The match that probably didn't happen there is going to happen here.
Wait. He's showing something now with Johnny Rhodes has something to say. Listen.
Ladies and gentlemen, I want to introduce you to another lady from Mexico.
Up and next out is Marcella, the Lady of Fire.
La Morena de Fuego. That's who she is, baby. She is a star in CMLL Mexico, where the rising sun of tequila sunrises is prominent. I know, because I do lots of it.
She just wants to start this match right now, eyeing up Marcella.
And this lady,
Cameron's flashing, someone exciting, Johnny Rogers on the mic right now.
We are looking at the WUW champion is going to be a great match. Marcella, unbelievable woman, been a superstar for many, many years. We are very lucky to have her here at the World of Unpredictable.
And Sumisaki entering now. The WUW Women's Champion from New Japan Wrestling is here. Wow. Oh, there we go.
That's right, Sumisaki. And all I have to say is, Bonzai!
Johnny Rod still admired that lady very much. Look at him still looking at her.
Yeah, Johnny, I think, likes Sumi.
Sumi, yeah.
Yeah, they'd be drinking sake later, maybe.
I have to laugh on that one there, Crusher.
Good, strong, good.
Wow, look at this.
Look how they stand. They stand like two predators looking to chomp on a piece of meat. And that meat is a sushi sake. Oh, no,
Sumisaki would not fall into that. She's too smart of a wrestler. You watch her outsmart and pull something out of her sleeve here. She always did it. She did it the last shows. Look for it this show.
Yeah, but I tell you right now, I bet you Skady is very ready for anything. There's not going to be a Pearl Harbor here, I tell you this time.
I would watch out. You never know. We're in this, like, showing the WUW title there. Everybody's taking their corners. Sumisaki, the champion, holding that belt. It might be her last time, might be she'll hold on to it. We don't know, but she's in for tough competition right now.
You know what? I'm going to make sure that you do not mess up with the words in the language of the Spanish. So I'm going to go get somebody right now before this match starts that's going to make things right. I'll be right back.
You were supposed to do the Spanish. What happened?
Listen, I'm going. I come right back. I have to get somebody. Excuse me. I know it's going to be difficult. You take on the match without me. I'll be right back.
Okay, they're all taking their corners now. It looks like what is going on now? There's some complaint being registered to Jonathan Ganji, the referee. Sumisaki is now looking out there, yelling something out. What is happening? Now what? She doesn't. Now she gets her feet checked. Let's get on with this match. The crowd is showing an uproar now. We want wrestling. We want wrestling. We're all taking our corners. Now what's going to happen? Two.
Okay, hello.
You're back.
Yes, I'm back. And now I come with somebody who knows how to talk. The unpredictable one himself, Mr. Rhodes.
Jay Heavy, how are you? I hear this gentleman over here have a problem with the Spanish speaking. He asked me, I guess he's been in Mexico. He says he needs help. Is that right, Colorado? I mean, what can I tell you? All I know, he wants me to say something about Sky D. Sky D, esta es la señora de Mexico que está buscando, bueno, creo que le está dando guerra a Marcela y la está persiguiendo desde México. Venido aquí a Nueva York a buscarla a ella. Y mira.
Wait. Looks like there's a team up there.
Bueno, esto es un problema lo que está pasando aquí. Es que Sky D está buscando el campeonato de WUW, que es un problema que está pasando. Que yo no sé, ella está muy entrada de Marcela. Y Marcela, ahora mismo, mira, tiene problemas porque esta es, yo no la voy a llamar un gigante, pero mira qué fuerte está. Está muy fuerte. Y yo no sé quién de este match o aquí en este, en el three ways que dicen acá, three way match. Yo no sé si es three way porque estilo mexicano. This is Mexican style three way match for people that don't know what's happening over here. And right now I'm also talking in English because I want to say in Spanish and English. This is a three way, but it's a Mexican style three way match. And I don't know if they, who's going to be who or what, how many times they're going to go. Because I hope the referee knows. Yo espero que el referee sepa lo que está pasando. Porque este estilo de lucha libre es lucha libre profesional de México. Y este es lo que está pasando en este eso. Y Sky D y Marcela son las más, el problema más grande. Y otro grande problema es que la japonesa Sumisaki es la campeona. Marcela está atrás de eso porque ella era la ex champion, la ex campeona. Y ella es CMML Superstar, Japan Superstar. Y está pasando mucho este match de lucha libre aquí profesional de WWE, ¿no? I don't know what else to tell you.
Well, you tell a lot, and that's why I bring you inside, because you say it like I could never say it. Well, Jay Heavy, what do you say have to say about this match? Look, it's Sky D is in the ring.
Well, in the beginning of the match, you heard it's like a team up. It looks like Sky D is teaming up with Sumisaki there. You saw the handshake, the hug, the attacks, Marcella. It looks like Sumisaki is out of the ring, thrown out, and it's like Marcella now is taking on Sky D here. It's a very interesting match. We'll see how this plays out. Is Sumisaki going to have enough to get back in the ring? Is it a surprise tactic?
Nice.
We're going to fall out. Beautiful.
I want to say something, good guys. Perdón. Yo estoy aquí mirando esto porque me trajeron aquí para que yo hablara un poquito en español porque ellos, en verdad, Kovalov, el ruso, y Jay Heavy, y lo que saben es muy poquito. Yo tampoco. Yo me crié aquí en Nueva York. Perdón que si no sé explicarles bien lo que está pasando, pero en verdad quiero decirle que esta muchacha Sky D, que es muy fuerte. Marcela tiene muchos problemas porque ella sabe todo de lucha libre de México, porque México, lucha libre, super lucha libre es una cosa muy grande en México y en todo el mundo.
Look.
Mira.
Surprise. Ahora mismo, mira para allá.
Whoa, señor. Did you just see that? Whoa.
Japonesa.
Y la japonesa está detrás de ella porque ella no quiere perder el campeonato.
That's
y ahora, look. Mira con quién se
está. Right, she's a friend. She begs for forgiveness. She's not know what she's doing.
Yo quiero decirle, sabiendo muchas cosas, tiene que tener cuidado con las japonesas, que las japonesas son muy listas.
Well, you saw that. Sumisaki did pull a surprise attack there. A double drop kick. She made up with Sky D and just turned on her again to take the pin. I don't think it's going to work a third time. Do you crush her?
Well, I tell you right now, Sumisaki is not stupid. She knows what she is doing. She has game plan. Game plan, baby. I tell you this.
Oh, no game plan no more. This is an outright brawl. Look at this. Returns a shot, Sumisaki. Another shot by Sky D.
There's going to be lots of handprints on
this. Oh, another ravishing shot there. A missed. Oh.
That's what I'm talking about. Take the shortcuts when you can, baby.
Look at that. It's going to be all Sumisaki. Oh, no, that just ended a kick.
Look, I want to explain one more thing here. Look at this. Look how strong this girl is. Let me explain in English and Spanish. Not only did this here is a match on a three-way, I don't know what style it is, American style, Japanese style, Mexican style. But
wait, the winner,
hey, doesn't matter. The winner of this match, or who it is, becomes champion. There is a return match right away coming in March 21st. Marzo 21. Ellas vienen para atrás, no importa quién sea la que campeona, hay una revancha y no sé quién va a ser de aquí. Mira para allá lo que está pasando. Esto, this is rough, guys.
This is rough, and you just saw Sumisaki saying that they cheated. They cheated. It now looks like the grudge match is taking place in Brooklyn here. Whoa, what a shot to Marcella. Crusher.
Tell you right now, what is done, and that is that. It is what it is, as Mr. Rod says all the time. And now it's down to a two-horse race. And let me tell you something. They do have, like, caballos in Mexico. They know how to ride.
A two count there. Wow, this is some match off the ropes. What's going to happen here? Sunset flip that didn't work. Oh, right on her face.
Drops the whole load on her chest. Crushing. And what? One, two, how much?
That's two a two. Count. Two. Jonathan counted two.
Referee is too
two,
slow.
Two.
No, I don't agree. I thought that was three.
No, that was a two count.
That was three.
You see Marcella holding her face. That was some drop on it.
Whoa, a shot
to the chest.
Nice. And nice clothesline.
Oh, another shot.
Esto es muy terrible lo que está pasando. Esta es una revancha que hay. Yo no sé de dónde viene.
Two.
Si viene de México, viene de Japón, o viene de Nueva York. No sé qué es lo que está pasando, pero parece que Sky D está muy mucho coraje contra esta la morena de fuego que viene siendo Marcella, una tremenda campeona, not only de WW, de CMML, de Japón, bueno, del mundo completo. Esta niña está en todas las partes del mundo luchando profesional y mira para allá, se defiende mucho. Y entonces yo creo que aquí Sky D tiene problemas con ella, pero ella tiene que pelear hasta el fin del mundo. Mira para allá como se tira donde quiera, mire.
Wow.
Esto es lo que está pasando, hay una revancha muy grande.
You just see that shot that Marcelo just delivered on Sky D, putting her into the front row of the crowd. They're both down on the concrete. Crusher, tell me what is going on here.
I'm telling you, it's Pier 6 brawl going on outside of the ring.
Well, I have to agree with you. This is
That's one match here.
It
took my breath away too, Mr. Rhodes. It's too
much. I do not know. I'm one way able to explain it to you.
On the top rope.
All I know that they're going at it really heavy.
She just caught her. You see the strength of her.
That's because, wow, nice, powerful move.
Two count.
Did you guys realize that this became more than just one fall?
Well, you know, it's three, four this people, is, three, four,
yeah,
maybe.
But this is Mexican style lucha libre. This is the lucha libre from Mexico.
Two.
They actually came out. This is something that has been signed up. Even the referee doesn't know what's going on because this Jonathan Ganji, one of the wrestlers that is a special referee, referee especial. Pero él no sabe ni lo que está pasando en esta clase de...
One, two, count.
Listen, all I remember from my time in Mexico is lots of Kahlua and lots of vodka.
Well, I don't know what to tell you. I have no idea.
Marcella holding her face is hurt. I got to break into this. Look like Sky D is going to the top rope. This could be it, fellas. We might have ourselves a new champion here. Oh!
Nobody's home. What happened this?
Marcella parece que se va a desquitar lo que está buscando la otra.
Look at this. Oh! Full load.
Wow.
One, two. A new champion. Let's watch it an instant replay. We're going to watch this full blow
Marcela
to the chest.
Se ha robado la correa que ella quería porque Marcela quiere ser la campeona otra vez y Sky D está en problemas.
Wow, low.
Bueno, yo creo que esto viene siendo el fin si hay un contado de tres veces. Uno, dos y tres.
Treasure,
y es la campeona Marcela.
Women's champion,
una
Marcela.
Vez más, la WW, World Unpredictable Wrestling campeona de aquí, y es Marcela. Esto va a ser tremenda revancha viniendo marzo 21, porque yo creo que ella viene. La otra está pidiendo revancha por todos los lados.
Wow, you got it there. We have a new women's champion here, Marcela. You just saw it. Wow, you saw one, what a Crusher says, a Pier 6 brawl. This was one match. Wow. Where else are you going to see this exciting action, huh?
What I said, I don't want to say nothing, guys. All I know is that you brought me here for me to actually try to explain. Mire, es la campeona y muy, muy, muy agradecido que ella es la campeona del mundo de WR aquí en Nueva York, en Gleason's Gym, que viene siendo un combate muy grande y ella está muy contenta. Mira para allá que como está ella diciendo, te espero al que sea, cualquiera que sea. Ahí está.
And that's it, fella. It's the match. New women's champion, Marcela. More action to come on March 21st. The power wheel is turning.
I am so happy. I am WW champion. My tag partner, David Finley, got belt from Germany. My tag team, best in the world.
Now, I've been all over the world. I've been plenty of places, and right now I am in the fabulous Brooklyn, New York, in Gleason's world famous gym. You see, we're at Johnny Rod's World of Unpredictable Wrestling. Coming up on January 17th, we've got the 30th anniversary show. Be there. Now, that's all great, but we've got two guys that think they can beat me and my partner here. Well, they're wrong. We've got Payaso Coco, a clown from Mexico. Well, it's not going to be fun and games. You're not gonna be laughing. You wanna go back to Mexico. We've got Money Mike Fire Zone. Well, you better save your money because the hospital bills are gonna be expensive. You both better hope Johnny Rods calls your moms and begs them not to let you out that night because it will not be pleasant for you. You see, we've got a champion right here. We've got a guy from New Japan. That's a lot. We've got another champion. I'm a fourth generation wrestler. I am a Finlay. And together, you can't stop us. Now, we're gonna beat you guys so bad. So bad that the pictures in your wallets are gonna cry, and you can take that to the bank.
January 17th.
That's right, welcome back to the world of unpredictable wrestling. Ape Street is in the ring. We're going live to ringside right now. Jonathan Ganji's our referee. We have the producer at ringside, our cameraman producer, Jay Heavy here.
TV star, this is Payaso Coco and his partner, Mike Firezone.
Well, I think he just announced Money Mike Firezone and the team of Payaso Coco. Here it is. Money Mike Firezone entering. He's all ready for this match. A lot of talk over the internet this week. A lot of talk over here in the world of unpredictable wrestling, the locker room. Payaso Coco, Mexican TV superstar, his tag team partner. These guys worked great as a team last time. It was an exciting match. But I have a feeling you're in store tonight. Money Mike has just grabbed the microphone. Let's go back to ringside and hear what he has to say.
Shut up for a minute.
Wow, the crowd reaction was that. I can't believe he just said that. Wow. This looks like it's going to be an exciting match. Money Mike is now challenging and putting down the team of Finley. He's going to have a problem with this Finley. Finley, fourth generation wrestler.
You might as well come out and hand me that belt.
Son of Finley from WWE.
And their opponent, he's a New Japan superstar. This is Takayaki
champion of POW Finley Jr., David Finley Jr.
The unpredictable one, Johnny Rod. Here's the European champion.
What's going on here? There's a little confrontation between Jonathan Ganji, the referee, and Money Mike. Wow, so wild. What are these guys chicken out on this team? Biazo Coco, great wrestler. King of the Lucha here. Whoa, there you are, our champion, our light heavyweight champion. Taka Aki Watanabe and David Finley Jr., son of Finley, WWE. Johnny Rods at ringside. There seems to be some type of rules changes going on. We're going to take you live to Johnny Rods on the side there, who just got the microphone. Here he goes.
Listen, Money Mike. I got some vocals. Let me get them, people. Let me get them. Listen, Mike. Have a little respect, okay? What? You're getting out of hand.
Money Mike arguing about something. Something's on. Here's our champion, Taka Aki Watanabe, WWE Light Heavyweight Champion from New Japan Wrestling.
Okay? Okay,
oh, look at him rubbing it in. Rubbing it into Money Mike. That championship belt is on the line here tonight in this tag team match, believe it or not. A little wave off. What's Johnny Rod saying now? Special rules. Whoa! Money Mike and Piazza Coco do not look too happy with this at all. Don't look too happy at all. A lot of pacing going on here. Johnny's still in the mic. It looks like 8th Street is writing something out. There's a little confrontation going on there between David Finley and Mike as 8th Street is talking here. Wow.
This is a special rule.
Money Mike does not look happy at all.
You know what happened to these guys? This gentleman here is from New Japan.
Piazza Coco just went after David Finley Jr. in the ring. Johnny's still on the mic. These special rules are aggravating a lot of people here. Money Mike is complaining.
And ladies and gentlemen, here's the champion. David Finley Jr. He's a European champion.
Well, it looks like David Finley Jr. is the POW Junior Champion. He's Finley's son from now, WWE, fourth generation wrestler. He's tagging up there with Tataka Akawabanabe from New Japan Wrestling. Johnny Rods is still on the mic. There's rules being changed left and right here. I am a little confused at what's going on here, but the WUW Light Heavyweight Championship belt is still online. Let's get this match underway. This David Finley Jr. is one hell of a wrestler. We're going to be in one hell of a match here. Money Mike Fire Zone is a little aggravated. You see Piazza Coco just sitting in the background. You really can't tell if he's aggravated enough with that mask on. Watanabe is smiling, rubbing it in.
And you guys got what you want. Signed by the Federal Letter Commission.
Oh, a last minute rubbing there. Taki Aki Watanabe rubbing it in. All right, this match is ready to start here. I'm going to bring in Johnny Rods into the commentator booth to go over these rule changes. I'm a little confused. They were broken up. There's interruptions by me and Money Mike and Piazza Coco. This match is underway. Wow. Money Mike is going to really show if he has it, because this David Finley Jr., fourth generation wrestler, son of Finley from the WWE, is taking now control of the match. Money Mike rolls out. Nice roll out. Now takes down. There. We're going to bring Johnny Rods in here. He's on his way in here to go over the rule changes. And here he is now. Johnny Rods.
What's going on? I'll be glad to help you. Jay Heavy, I don't know what is it that you... somebody asked me to explain to you what's going on with this match. Well, I could tell you, not only that confused, actually the whole story here is that Watanabe, who's the WWE heavyweight champion, is on a tag match, but Payaso Coco and this Money Mike Firestorm, because he's got a lot of money, and I think he's doing something with the Payaso Coco, got to do with the dollar sign, and he some kind of bent things around, got his own way about saying that between both of them, if they could get pin Watanabe at any time in this match, whoever pins Watanabe in this match, this is a special rule that we actually got caught on for this match. If they could pin Watanabe, any of these two guys, I'm talking about Payaso Coco or Money Mike Firestorm, they could wind up being the heavyweight champion. This is a special rule on a tag match, not the anything else. It's just thereafter Watanabe's belt. This rules was made, and somehow we got signed in. It is in, and this is the match. This is what it's all about. That's why I had to come in and try to actually explain to the people what's going on, because they're gonna see. They say, what's this all about? It's supposed to be one-on-one for somebody to be a champion. All of a sudden, this is going on crazy. But this is what the story is about. I hope I can explain it right enough.
Well, that's a very good explanation. There's a lot of talk about some behind the scenes between Money Mike and Piazza trying to figure this out. And dollar signs are probably involved. I know Money Mike has had problems now with Nero and Stefaru with some hedge fund deal that Money Mike shammed with. So Money Mike is creating enemies and trying to create as many friends as possible here in the WUW. But let's go back to this match. It looks like it's a Piazza Coco Money Mike match, taking full control of this match.
Well, I could tell you, starting from Payaso Coco, which is this gentleman, I call him a gentleman because he's a very rough guy. I don't know. I never saw his face because he hides under the Payaso Coco, meaning he's one of the clowns, a superstar from Mexico, TV star. And he is here in New York. He's been hanging around WW. He became very good friends with Money Mike Firestorm, and they've been working all kinds of rules. These guys get together. They're very dangerous. And then, you know what? Even Takaaki Watanabe doesn't even have an idea what is it that that's going on with
Well, you got a point there, what's going on. But here's a very important thing that I have to bring up. And guess what? Why don't you break the news about our featured ladies match on March 21st?
Well, I'll tell you what. March 21st, now since I'm glad. Thank you for reminding me. That's one of the biggest grudge matches that's going to go on WWE on March 21st, because Marcella getting back the belt, the championship belt from Sumi Saki, which is a great lady wrestler from Japan, and she happened to take back the belt because she was looking for it. This Sky D, a star from CMNW, a star from Japan. This girl is a monster. She's after Marcella for whatever grudge she's got after Marcella from Mexico. Yo quiero hablar en español también, decirle que Marcella está en un problema muy grande. ¿Por qué? Quiero explicarle. Sky D, una luchadora muy grande de CMML Estado de México, está detrás de la correa de campeonato con Marcella, pero no era tanto eso. Ella estaba detrás de Marcella, pero ahora que Marcella es campeón, ahora es más grande que ella está encima con él. Lo que nosotros le llamamos grudge match, que viene siendo una cosa de coraje, no sé por qué, pero el día marzo 21, aquí en Gleason's Gym, en el 77 de Front Street, en Nueva York, Brooklyn, va a estar tremenda lucha contra Marcella y Sky D. Sky D es tremenda y Marcella tiene un problema muy grande. I'm going to tell you, Marcella is in trouble. Marcella has got a lot of trouble because Sky D is very strong and they have a grudge match and she's after the belt right now, more than the grudge match. Now she's got something, Marcella's got something to worry about, because she's, if this girl grabs her and beats her, then she becomes the WUW champion and this is what's going on March 21st.
Well, you heard it March 21st. I just went on the internet and looked at some of these matches, these grudge matches from CMLL, and they were brutal matches, and you're going to see one great match here on March 21st. Tickets are on sale, 718-797-2872. That's 718-797-2872. Well, in this match going on here, it looks like Money Mike has got David Finley Jr.'s number, and it's just been a total beatdown. Piazza Coco comes in here, makes an appearance, but it looks like this is a one-sided match right now. Money Mike is now making his statement, showing, I don't care whose son you are. You're in Money Mike's territory. Look at this.
I'm going to tell you, this Money Mike somehow has been hanging around with Payaso Coco, which he learned what you call Super Lucha Libre Mexicana, Mexican-style pro wrestling, Lucha Libre Profesional de México, que es tremenda lucha libre, y parece que el Payaso Coco, mucho estudio para Mike Firestone, y Finley tiene un problema, Tahaki Watanami tiene otro problema, parece que tienen los rules esos que tienen, these rules that they made up, somehow están adelante, they are ahead a whole lot. Let me tell you, this is tremendous matches going on. Look at what Takaaki is going crazy.
He's
right
crazy.
Now because he doesn't
dying
want
to get in there.
They don't want to lose this match. Look at this. What a comeback is going on. Let me explain something to you. If any of these guys grab this belt, these guys, this is going to go on all year. And then I don't know who's going to come back, but I think there's a challenge between Maya Mike Fire Zone has been in single challenge grudge match still against Finley Jr. And Finley Jr. is the son of Finley Sr., which is one of the superstars in WWE, great wrestlers. And they're from Europe, they're great wrestlers. And the kid is a champion from Europe. And he's over here in trouble right now because these two guys are looking all after these titles and all after this. I don't know. You could call it fame or you could call it anything you want.
Well, that's true. Just going back real quick, there was an advertisement there. For any wrestlers out there, managers or referees, we have ongoing training here. Hall of Famer Johnny Rods, call up. The number was there. Please join us. Don't dream about it. Don't think about it. Get in it. Wow, did you just see that? Let's watch that on instant replay, Johnny.
I can tell you, here's Money Mike in a lot of trouble with Takaaki Watanami. Takaaki Watanami is a very good wrestler. But look at this. Payaso Coco knows all the tricks, my brother.
Look
what he just did. He sent them right across the ring and defended his partner. They're really going after somebody. That replay shows you everything, how much power these guys have. They're not ready to lose this match. They're not ready at all, Jay Heavy.
Well, that's true. That's true. It looks like they have the upper hand in this match right now. Finley is hurt. He's grabbing onto Mike's boot there. It looks like now Piazza Coco is going to slam down. Oh!
He tried.
Watanabe saved himself there. Wow, I tell you.
I'll tell you one thing. I'm going to tell you something about Watanabe. Watanabe is a New Japan superstar wrestler.
Like,
and let me tell you, you need this much power to get this man over. This man is a good Japanese wrestler. He wrestles all over. He's the champion here. He's all over the place. And let me tell you, these guys better have something special to be able to beat Watanabe. And look, they keep sending...
Here it goes. Wow, that's 300 pounds crashing down on Watanabe's chest. Johnny, wow, did you just see that?
I don't believe this. Did
Mike
you see
trying to save the pin. It looks like a two count.
Oh,
another
my God.
Two
almost.
Count.
Almost. Look at that. He can't believe it himself.
Well, this is the action we have down
did
here.
Did you see what Payaso Coco tried to do? This guy's a 300-pound guy. Did you see what he did? I don't know. What do you call that? The triple, double, somersault, whatever you call it?
It's a double somersault.
And he landed
back there.
Look at this. Look at this.
No. Oh, he just hit his own tag team partner, Money Mike. What a, he's now going after Watanabe. Watanabe ducks. Whoa.
Oh my God.
Outsmarted. Look at him just throwing him into that corner there like he was a piece of, just like a sack of.
Look at this. Wacko.
The spear.
Oh my God, look at this spear. And one, two, three.
Oh my God. A big upset.
Look at how lucky these guys got. Can you imagine? combination together, how great these guys are defending. What a great match. I can't believe it. Look at Finley Jr. Wait a second. And he's ready to take on and give it
to... Wait a second. That was a two count. What is going on here? I thought that was a three count.
Oh, no. Oh, my God.
This is confusing. I thought it was a three count. They had their hands up. The referee put his two fingers out. Finley just took Piazza Coco and drove him to the front row there, jumping off the ring, and now it's official. It is official. Wow.
You know, you were fool. I was fool. This is how fast this thing went. These guys are really fine. Look at this. They made it all the way. Well, there you go. Takaaki Watanabe and Dave Finley Jr., great tag team guys. And listen,
a great match.
Look
he
at this.
Is now
Piazza is sorry.
Wobbly. Look at
he's
that.
Wobbly.
Look, the producer is helping him over there. He's out.
Look at the crowd. The crowd going crazy. This is amazing what these guys... Look at what Tanami... He says, I did it, brother.
I did it. They did it. Look at this. This is one great match. We were a little confused there. We saw the three count the last second.
Unbelievable.
I didn't know why Finley was going to the side there, but he just jumped up Piazza Coco.
I'm telling you, I tell you what. Finley Jr., I'm looking at a superstar here in WWE. Very soon, all over the world, because look at this kid, and look at what the name. I got you, brother. Oh my God! Well, great tag team. You've seen it on WWE. That's the World Unpredictable Wrestling. I hope that we come back for some kind of a grudge match for March 21st, because I'm telling you, that's the
big
one coming up. Yeah, March 21st here at Gleason's Gym. We're gonna do it again, and hope that the fans enjoy this one. And, Jay Heavy, what do you think?
Well, first of all, happy 30th anniversary. This has been a great show. It's great having you up here. We had the Crusher in here, Money Mike Fire Zone. This is one great show, and there's more to come on March 21st. Go to our website, wuwonline.com, or call for your tickets now, 718-797-2872. Don't miss out on our next show. It's just getting better and better.
I'm glad everybody was down for the inauguration of the 30 years, and all the fans came in to enjoy it, and I have all these great stars in here. Thank you.
Thank you.